What's up, everyone? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and today I want to talk about what the best language is to use for your coding interview. So what is the best language to use for your coding interview? Well, it's Python, right? Obviously, Python's a really easy language to use. You can write really concise code with it. So why not just use that for all of your coding interviews? Well, today I want to talk about five different things that you can think about when you're actually trying to decide what language to use in your interview, because it's not always going to be that simple. So first of all, we have to ask ourselves, is the job that we're looking at language specific? And that's going to depend a lot on the sort of role we're looking for. Because if we're looking at like a Google or a Facebook and we're looking at that just software engineering role, the role is obviously going to be in a specific language, but those companies aren't going to care what language we actually interview in, because their assumption is going to be that we're going to learn whatever the technologies are that we need once we start the job. And that means that we can really choose whatever language we want. However, if you are looking at a language-specific role like an Android dev or an iOS dev, for example, then you're definitely going to want to use one of those languages. So you may still have some options, like with iOS, you could use Objective-C or you could use Swift, but within those narrow parameters, you're going to want to stick to those languages that are relevant. But let's say that you don't have a language-specific job. What do you look at next? The second question that we ask ourselves is, what is your best language? I hear a lot of people who think that they should learn a new language like Python because it's going to be easier for them to use in their interviews rather than using the languages that they already know. And I think this is a terrible, terrible idea. You're going to spend so much time learning this new language, and then on top of that, you're actually not going to know nearly as many of the nuances of the language as you would if you just used a language that you were good at to begin with. So it's much better for you to focus on, if you're a C developer, for example, just use C. Yes, it's going to be more verbose. Yes, there are things that are going to be kind of a pain in the ass, but you're going to be so much more comfortable programming in C than you are going to be in Python that it's absolutely not worth it to try and learn Python just for your interview. So now question number three, what if you have multiple languages that you're equally good at? What do you do? Well, what language in this case is going to be easier to interview with? So for example, using ANSI C is going to be much harder than using C++ or using Java, because you're going to have to do all of this memory management. And that's just going to make your life so much more difficult. So if you have multiple languages that you are equally good at, then it is worthwhile to pick the language that is going to be easier to interview in. Number four, how easy is it for other people to understand the language that you're using? This is something that I think a lot of people overlook, but if you're still stuck deciding which language to use, it's really important that your interviewer actually be able to understand what you're doing. So a good example of this is, what if you were trying to decide between, say, Java and Ruby? Well, unless you're actually going into a place where they do a lot of Ruby development, I know for me personally, Ruby is actually kind of a confusing language to look at compared to my experience, which is C-based languages. And so the majority of developers who went to school these days still have that C background and that Java background. And so going that direction is going to make it easier for your interviewer to understand what it is that you're doing in your interview and how you're writing the code, and it will make it easier for them to help you. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. And then the final question that you have to ask yourself is, what languages do the company actually use? So if there's a language that you are feeling comfortable with that the company actually uses internally, that again goes along with the previous question that we asked about whether it's easy to understand, because it's going to be so much easier for those employees who are interviewing you to understand the language or understand the code that you're writing if you're writing in a language that they're familiar with. So just to recap, those five questions that you have to ask yourself are, is the job language specific? What is your best programming language? How easy is it to interview in that programming language? How easy is it for other people to understand that language? And what languages do they use at the company? So if you go through those, you should have an easy time identifying what is going to be the best language for you personally to use in your interviews. And once you've identified the language, it's so important to practice and practice and practice doing coding interviews in that language. I've talked to people who want to do some problems in one language and some problems in another. And while you can do that, you're going to be so much better off just focusing on one language and getting really, really good at that and doing interviews in that language. Even when I was working as a Go developer, I actually kept doing interviews in Java because that was just what I was familiar with. And they're pretty similar languages, so it wasn't super confusing. But keeping that focus in that one language is going to make a huge difference and is going to make it way, way easier for you to succeed in your interviews. So if you like this video, please click subscribe below. And if you want to download my free ebook on dynamic programming, you can do that over at dynamicprogrammingbook.com. And I look forward to talking to you again soon.